What up, guys? Adrian here again. It's another brute shoot. Today we're addressing the accessory work. And I say that in air quotations because I'll tell you what, everyone and their mom in the sport of fitness is really fired up about accessories nowadays. And while they have importance, sometimes we're overvaluing or misplacing our focus on our training because we're drawn to the sexiness or the easiness and the convenience of these accessory work movements. Now, we're not talking about accessories, I'm talking about like your single arm strict press and your upright pulls and your bent over rows, your curls, your reverse curls, your skull crushers. Maybe we're doing something where we're doing unilateral farmer carries, like we're building our bodies, right? So essentially it's like bodybuilding style workouts or movements that can either lead to a more sound structure so that when we do high intensity functional movements constantly varied that you get injured less, or maybe your power output's higher, or maybe you perform at a higher level. And so they carry great value. My advice to you guys is to keep first things first, however. Like, don't forget the origins of what CrossFit has built its foundation, and that's the high intensity proponent of the sport. If we keep that, our meat and potatoes of our training. So that means when you guys go into the gym, you have a great warm up. And hopefully you guys are part of a community that is wise in how they program. You're a part of a coaching staff, or you're led by a coaching staff that takes consideration into how many times you're going overhead in a week and how many times you're pulling vertically versus horizontally, and all these things that need to be considered in regards to health and joint, you know, exposure to movements, making sure that we're not becoming redundant. But the point is, keep high intensity and power output movements first, right? Dive in headlong to the suffering and the cutting back on every split second or every half second that you can on each round and workout, because that is where the greatest value and the change on the leaderboard is really going to happen for you when it comes to local competitions, when it comes to online qualifiers, when it comes to the CrossFit games, the open, the regional, and the games themselves. Like, that's where we make our real money. And I wanted to preface the accessory work part with that because I think a lot of people are actually switching those things around now, right? Like, they might've been doing CrossFit for a while and they're like, oh, coach, like, I want to do something different. They want to do accessory movements more so, right? And they want to do functional bodybuilding. And all those things, again, are great. But you got to understand your athletic background. So let me paint a picture. I have been lifting weights and training foundational strength movements, multi-joint strength movements, explosive, powerful strength movements from the time that I was 16 years old. This is much longer than the majority of the training ages of CrossFitters across the world, right? Because you found this by walking into a gym in your mid-20s or your early 30s or your late 30s or your early 40s, and it beat your body up a little bit. You might have not been ready for the loads and the intensity that you were exposing yourself to, but that's not because you need extra other work. That's because you had an error in who led you on how to scale movements and how to scale intensity. You came in ready to bite the head off of everyone in the gym already, and you wanted to win, and you wanted to get first, and you didn't want to swallow your pride and scale the weight, right? So there's some great value in you just stepping back and looking at actually how you started. What's your movement quality like? Are you putting into practice mechanics consistency and then intensity, or was it the opposite? Because more often than not, it was the opposite. Now, with a training background like mine, right, with all the muscle contractions that I amassed over the years, with all the heavy lifting, someone like me can really, really get a great benefit and great result from adding in that structural, single joint, unilateral work that creates longer time under tension and a bit less intensity. But it's because I'd been doing it for so long in my years past. If you're new to CrossFit by ways of like, hey, 5 years and Adrian, the first time I did a clean and jerk was the first time I stepped into CrossFit, your training history is very different than mine. It's very different than guys out there leading the functional bodybuilding movements and the guys that are looking so great with no shirt on. It's all great stuff, but you have to keep in mind how different you are than them. Their training background really dictates the way their body responds to some of those movements and some of those lifts. So when you're considering accessory work, think about keeping first things first. High intensity, functional movements, do them hard, do them fast, right? And then add in accessory work, and don't make that the emphasis of your training. Use that as icing on the cake. If you wanna do more upright pulls because you notice a structural imbalance, or you're getting advice from someone that notices one of those things, then do it. But do it after you've already depleted most of your effort and energy into pushing your fitness forward by means of intensity, because the results are going to be greater. So cool downs, warm ups, add in the presses, add in the lunges, add in the step ups. They are going to help keep your joints healthier for longer periods of time and help keep your body balanced the way that you need to be.